Hey guys, welcome back to the garden. It's mid-November and I thought I'd just take you through the food forest and another part of the garden. Just a fall tour of what's going on in the garden right now and some of the work that's happening. So let's go inside. I really enjoy these beautiful fall colors and the smell in the garden. We've just had a lot of rain, which is wonderful, and it makes the soil much easier to work, to plant in, move a lot of plants. That's usually what I do around this time of year. And I think the falling of the leaves is beautiful. You see, this is a bladder nut. And when the leaves are falling off, you see how beautiful the bark is. So new things are coming out in this time of year. And this especially is so beautiful right now. It's called a monkey's bottom. Well, actually, monkey's ass maybe, but it's a Mispel Royal, and you can make a sweet sort of sauce or dessert with these fruits. I think they're beautiful. They're not quite ripe yet. Actually, they usually need the first frost, and then they can be harvested. In the garden, my mom has helped me cut back a lot of the dead things. That's really wonderful. I'm very grateful for the help. And it makes it easier to move around and move stuff in the garden. So right now, I wanted to show you also these amazing Japanese lanterns. They are just so bright this time of year, and I think they're beautiful. They're also delicious, edible, in the family of ground cherries. Lots of other beautiful things I wanted to show you. We've just felled a lot of big trees, so you see I've actually been able to put a thick layer of compost, not compost, but what are the these are wood chips, of course. So this will keep the pathways a lot longer than usual. I'm very pleased with that. It also means that I have less work in spring. And this, my good friend Lotte gave me these beautiful flowers. They are very late flowering, so beautiful and bright. I think it's a winter aster. There's another beautiful thing here. Some of the roses are still flowering. Incredible. And lovely, lovely scented roses here. I don't remember the name, but that's not important. Beauty is. So, and there's another one. This is a pineapple sage. It actually shouldn't be able to winter in the garden, but this one is about 1.40 meters tall, and it's actually, I think, maybe 3 years old now. So it winters in the garden. I'm very pleased with that. So beautiful. And right beside it is this Szechuan pepper. You see the pepper seeds are coming out. Maybe if I can catch it here. Yeah, you see they're so beautiful in the sunlight. And lovely, lovely smell in the garden. And in the kitchen. So we are nearing the end of the fall colors, as you can see. But then other things become visible, and I enjoy that very much. A friend helped me cut back actually quite heavily some of the trees so that it's easier to move around the garden and work and shift plants around. But we are coming over to this great and beautiful, this is a strawberry tree. And it's flowering now. It's one of the latest flowering plants I have in the garden. And look how beautiful. Just these tiny bell flowers hanging. I think it's amazing. And it's evergreen. And I just think it's so beautiful this time of year. And if there's a bumblebee out late, there's always something delicious for them. So I'm enjoying that very much. I doubt that I will ever have any strawberry fruits on this tree, but hey, it serves other purposes in the garden, so that's quite nice. I have cut back on some of the pathways, so it's easier to move around. And another thing I wanted to show you here, this tree has been, I think you call it coppiced. So we simply cut it down like 1.5 meters above ground. This is a lime tree, Tilia cordata. And I have this tree, I think it's a beautiful tree, but I have it because I eat the leaves. I like it very much in salads. It's a nice green taste, and this tree keeps producing new fresh leaves all summer. So it's a really good thing to easy thing to harvest for the salad bowl. But this tree will shoot from lots of small shoots, so I will have a lot more leaves to harvest when I coppice it this way. So that's why I've done it. And you will also see that actually it gives me more light in this area, which is nice for some of the ground crops growing here. Look at the beautiful color of the hosta leaves. It's falling right now, so beautiful. Another one of my favorite late crops, it's actually second time it's coming this year. This is a French sorrel. I think it's called de Belleville, and it's one of my favorite crops. Very early, actually, I usually can harvest from it all winter, and it gets tired during the summer, hottest summer months, and then it grows back this time. But in spring and fall, it's a delicious crop in the garden. Yes. So this is what it looks like in its fall dress. I mean, still lots of color and flowers actually to both to pick from and eat. And you see this beautiful tree also. This is Judas tree. It's a red bud, Cercis silicastrum. That's one of my favorite nitrogen fixers. Edible pink flowers in spring, and then you have these amazing seed pods, lots and lots and lots, all winter hanging there. I think it's a spectacular tree, and then it also does community service in terms of fixing nitrogen. I love it. And still some edible cosmos flowering here. And I also often, I usually leave quite a lot of the seed pods. I don't cut everything back because I think it looks amazing. You see these thistles. These are Kartebolle. I don't know what they are in
English, but they stay very upright all winter, and they're so beautiful with frost or raindrops on them. So yeah, that's just the shapes coming out. It's more like a more graphical garden in the winter and fall. So we are moving back towards the spiral and the monkey's bottom. Yes. Beautiful afternoon sunlight in the garden. You see these apples. I harvested most of these apples yesterday afternoon. Some have fallen. That's okay. That's for the birds. But this variety I really, really, really love. It's, as you can see, it's very prone to disease. It's called Mutsu, and the taste is amazing, but it's very prone to disease. So it's not often you can buy them, at least not organic. But I love to grow them because they are, even if they look like this, the taste is amazing. So that's okay. You can peel it if you don't want to eat it, but the taste is really amazing. So Mutsu apples, I enjoy that. And the tree seems sort of healthy, but they always get these strange spots. That's okay. You can also see in the ground layers that a lot of the kale and the purple broccolis are bouncing back after a really, really dry summer. So I'm expecting to have lots and lots of delicious broccoli in a few months. That's wonderful. We've had so many quince this year. I haven't really had time to use them much, but delicious, and they smell so nice. Even if you just put them in a bowl in the living room, this sweet, delicious smell. I might take in a few. And we are now back at the gate. Thank you very much for joining me. See you later.